Hello, everyone. I'm Pastor Joseph Zhang. Nice to meet you again. This is the third session of my Bible video series. Today's topic is eternal forgiveness of sin. Everyone, what do you think you should do to receive forgiveness of sin? Have you been receiving forgiveness of sin by confessing your sin through prayer to God every day? God gave us the word, which is the Bible. We must receive salvation and do our spiritual life precisely based on the Bible. In the Bible, Hebrews chapter 9, verse 22 says that without shedding of blood, there is no remission. Remission means the forgiveness of sin, all right? Why is shedding of the blood needed for forgiveness of sin? It is because Romans chapter 6, verse 23 says that the wages of sin is death. Okay, the wages of sin is death. But why is shedding of blood needed? Leviticus chapter 17, verse 11 says that the life of the flesh is in the blood. That means the blood is the life. Now then, what does shedding of blood mean? It is the proof that something has died. Jesus died on the cross by pouring out all his blood. That is why shedding of blood means that the debt was paid. I repeat myself, the wages of sin is death. Therefore, for us to receive forgiveness of sin, we must pay the debt. It's not that you should confess your sins by prayer. You must pay the debt. Sin can be washed away only with blood. And so, even in the Old Testament, to receive forgiveness of sin, the sinner had to kill a lamb, and its blood had to be offered on the altar of God on its behalf. The sin offering in the Old Testament is a model of Jesus, because in the New Testament, Jesus is called the Lamb of God. Now, let us see how forgiveness of sin was received in the Old Testament. Leviticus chapter 4, verse 32. If he brings a lamb as his sin offering, he shall bring a female without blemish. Here, without blemish means Jesus who came without sin. Female means Jesus who gives life. The sinner would say like this, Lamb, I'm sorry, please die by shedding your blood instead of me for my sins to be forgiven. Let's read verse 33. Then he shall lay his hand on the head of a sin offering and kill it as a sin offering at the place where they kill the burnt offering. Now here, before a sinner kills the lamb, he must lay his hand on its head. Let's look at Leviticus chapter 1, verse 4. Then he shall put his hand on the head of the burnt offering, and it will be accepted on his behalf to make atonement for him. What is written here? The sinner must lay his hand on the head of a lamb. That's when God accepts the lamb as a sin offering for the sinner. Do you understand this? Why can't a lamb be a sin offering unless it receives laying of hands? For the answer, let's read from Leviticus chapter 16, verse 21. Aaron shall lay both his hands on the head of the live goat, confess of it all the iniquities of the children of Israel and all their transgressions concerning all their sins, putting them on the head of the goat, and shall send it away into the wilderness. Now here, you can see the reason for laying of hands on the head of the sin offering, right? Laying of hands means the transference of sin. the lamb does not have sin. The reason why the lamb has to die is because the sin of the sinner was transferred onto the lamb by laying of hands. Do you understand the meaning of the laying of hands? 2,000 years ago, there was the time when the Lamb of God, Jesus, received the laying of hands. Do you know that? And who did he receive it from? Yes, from John the Baptist, right? This is the secret. I will explain in more detail later. Now, let us do the ceremony of transferring sin. The sinner brings a lamb without blemish before the priest. The priest checks whether the lamb has any blemish or not. Yes, there is no blemish in this lamb. This lamb qualifies to be the sin offering. And then the sinner lays his hand on the head of the lamb to transfer his sins. He laid his hand on the lamb. Now, something dark is being transferred to the lamb from the sinner, right? Yes, it's now transferred. What is transferred? It's the sin. The lamb without sin now became a lamb with sin. Our Lord Jesus did the same, right? Do you see that? Yes, this sinner became righteous. Why is that so? It's because his sin was transferred to the lamb. If you were the sinner in the Old Testament to receive the forgiveness of your sin, you would have had to lay your hand on the head of the lamb to transfer your sins. Now, the important thing is, how do you know whether your sins are transferred onto the lamb or not? Can your eyes see that the sin is being transferred? No. With your eyes, you cannot see that. Then, how can you believe it? Through the word of God. Because God promised that the sin would transfer. Let me ask you, would God lie? No, God does not lie. Whether you believe it or not is your choice, but that is what the Bible says. In the word of God, after laying your hand on the head of the lamb, there are no more sins in your heart. Afterward, what does the sinner do with the lamb? The sinner must kill the lamb. Leviticus chapter 4, verse 34. The priest shall take some of the blood of the sin offering with his finger, put it on the horns of the altar of the burnt offering, and pour all the remaining blood at the base of the altar. The sinner takes a sharp knife from the priest's hand and grabs the lamb's neck and stabs the artery to get its blood. The lamb sheds its blood, falls over, and dies. Then the priest takes the blood of the lamb and paints the four horns of the altar red with the lamb's blood. Why? It's because the blood is to certify that the wages of sin is death. After that, the rest of the blood is poured out at the bottom of the altar. Finally, all the leftovers are burned on the altar. Then the offering is finished. And then that sin was forgiven and that sin was paid for his soul. This is the sin offering in the Old Testament. However, this message is not eternal. It only lasts until you commit a sin again. After a few hours, you can commit a sin again, right? Then again, you must bring a lamb as an offering for your sin. So you must continually kill lambs, because that sin offering cleanses only the sin of that time. Therefore, God gave a better way to wash away all the sins of the people. This way was to wash away all the sins eternally just by one sacrifice. This way was very easy, right? This will be further explained in the next session. Thank you for listening. Let's meet again next time.